Good morning. We are the NG I2I group. Our project is real-time communication with WebRTC. I am Yash Trivedi, he is Rishabh Verma, and that is Omkar. Now, what is the motivation behind this? We wanted to enable plugin-free real-time audio and video communication. Now, as already introduced, Panorama is a video conferencing app already developed at CDEEP. It uses RTMP and Flash. Nowadays, the usage of Flash is being discouraged. Some of the reasons are, it requires a plugin. It is being given limited support by web browsers and devices by the vendors. And it has a long history of security flaws, malware, and bugs. Now, WebRTC, that is the core technology behind our project. It stands for Web Real-Time Communications. What it does is, it enables audio and video streaming and data sharing between browser clients without requiring any intermediary. It does not require the user to install any plugin or any other third-party software. It has three main components. First is Get User Media. It allows you to access the user's camera and microphone. Second is RTC Peer Connection that sets up the audio and video calls. Last is RTC Data Channel that allows you to share data via peer-to-peer. Now, this is the basic diagram. So this is client one, client two. Client one wants to talk to client two. So it sets up an offer and sends it through the server. The client two processes the offer. It sends an answer. And he processes the answer. Now, all the data that will be sent will be from peer to peer. No need for this server. So peer to peer, video, audio, or data. Now, let's talk about the solution that we developed. We have three different access control levels. First is the administrator. He is the head of the meeting. He's a necessary entity. He can grant controller permissions. What exactly are those permissions? I'll be coming to that. Thirdly, he can mute or unmute any meeting participant, any user. Now, controller. Controller can draw on the canvas. So we have a whiteboard where the controller can draw. Then he can share his presentation, a PPTX file, and he can stream local videos. And then we have a general user. To elaborate on the features, Omkar.
So now I will be talking about the features of our application. The main feature is, of course, the video conferencing part. We have implemented a room concept. So whenever a user will log in into a room, he will see the list of all the participants in the room. Next, if there is any bandwidth limitation, then a user can disable the video and enable only the audio. Then we have the chatting feature. We have the public room chat as well as the private user chat. Then we have presentation and video sharing. So a user can upload a local file, a presentation or a video file, and he can show it to all the other participants. And the presentation controls will be with the controller only. Only he can change the slides. Next, we have whiteboard sharing. In whiteboard sharing, we have used Canvas. We have Canvas. So in the toolbar, the options which you have are freehand drawing. Then we have shapes, line, rectangle, circle, triangle. We can insert an image from a local image, and we can also add text. We can edit the shapes, we can resize them, change color, we can change the layering. Then we can save the image on the client side as well as the server side as a PNG file. Then if a conference is going on and a user joins late, then the current state of the canvas will be transmitted to him and he can continue with the conference. So our application is accessible across various devices like mobile phones, tablets, and of course, PCs. The key technologies which you have used are
this is our panel. Here, Yash has joined our room. Room name is Demo. As you can see, the first participant joining the room will be the admin as well as the controller, because admin is a necessary entity for a meeting. Now, Omkar will also join the same room. And we have two participants in our meeting. As it is displayed on the left top corner, the number of meeting participants. We also have the time showing the time since beginning and the date of the meeting. We have several modes, as we discussed in our presentation. And we are now at videos mode. And as you can see, their username and room name is displayed. On the right side, we have all the participant list presently present in our room. Here, yes, this is the yes screen. And it's shown that Omkar is present. This icon is for private chat, and this is for get audio. This chat is only transmitted to Omkar. As you can see, yeah. Omkar received the message. Omkar will reply it.
What am I seeing?
Yes, sir.
Am I seeing one machine or I'm seeing two machines?
So you are seeing two machines. This one is displayed on there, and this one is there. These are two different machines. Both of them are connected.
If two different machines want to talk to each other.
Yes, sir.
When I do Skype, my machine should be smaller, no?
So smaller?
Correct. And the other fellow should be big.
So yes, we have also an option for making our video large. We just click on the video. It will be shown.
The other fellow is gone.
No, sir. It's below.
That is gone.
Sir?
There should be something called PIP, no? Picture in picture.
Okay.
Standard Skype. Why you are going away from standard Skype and giving me 100 screens?
Only the difference, just let me intervene. The difference between the thing is that Skype, what we generally see is the peer-to-peer, one-on-one.
Correct.
This is a multi-party conferencing. That is why this is 1-2. Even they attach 3, 4, 5, all the windows will come together. And the person he want to listen, he can make bigger. So suppose who is talking, right now I am talking, it will be bigger one, rest of that will be the smaller one.
So say you have one more participant, his video will be over here. One more, his video will be over here. So these are like, I have two participants right now. Say I have four, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's just a grid of all the participants and their videos.
What is the bandwidth requirement?
Sir, per stream, it is 75 kilobytes. Per stream. Okay.
And this thing, this whatever compression, etc., is done by WebRTC, who is doing it?
It is done by WebRTC.
This is, we have done the private chat. This is a room chat. All the messages sent to this room chat will be broadcasted to all the users present in the room. Now, if a user wants only to hear the audio of another user, he will just click that button present over right. Now, Yash is receiving audio of Omkar and but Omkar doesn't has any effect on his screen. He's receiving the video of Yash. Now we will switch back to video for Omkar. Now, we will switch to presentation mode because Yash is the controller. If we navigate to presentation mode, all the users are forced to navigate to the presentation mode. Because Yash is the controller, he can only see the uploading form. Presentation has been uploaded. And now we can start with the presentation. Here you can see, yes, at Omkar screen, we can also see the presentation. It is broadcasted to all the users present in the room. Now controller have the controls for navigating through the presentation. And while navigating, all the users will be on same slide. We can go on first slide. We can go on last slide. We can switch between the slides, and here is the slide number for the reference of controller. Now, here is the presenter video who is currently presenting this presentation. Now, we will switch to video stream mode. Likewise, we have shown you the presentation. We can also upload any video. It will also broadcast it to all the users present in the room. As you can see, the video has been transmitted to all the users.
What was the first mode? This one. Video. What is this one?
So this is video mode.
Where you see all the videos.
Correct.
And we have shown you presentation and video stream mode. Now as Yash is the admin, Yash will make the Omkar the controller to control canvas, presentation and video. As you can see, Omkar had requested through the room chat that I want to become the controller. Now Omkar is the current controller. He's on his screen, we can see that he's the controller. Now Omkar has switched to canvas mode and Yash is also brought to the canvas mode. We have a whiteboard shown to all the users and the toolbar which is accessible only to the controller. Now, on the toolbar, we have several options. Omkar is now typing the text. Now Omkar is drawing a line, which is transmitted in real time to all the user present. We are drawing a circle. We can draw any shapes, square, triangle, and now we have also an option to upload an image to a canvas. Now this image is uploaded to the canvas and it is transmitted to Yash also. Now we can erase, we can resize our eraser size through this brush width. And now we will switch to edit scene. In the toolbar, we have two modes. One's draw mode for drawing the shapes, freehand drawing, and another is edit the scene. In edit the scene, we can resize, we can change the color of any figure, and we can rotate it. We can do whatever we want, and it will be transmitted to each and every user. We can bring our object in the front. We can send it back also. And we can undo, draw a figure, Omkar. We can undo, this figure will be, this figure is gone, and we'll redo, this figure is up on the screen. Now, Yash will be joining with one more client to the same room. Yes, Yash has joined with one more client, and as you can see, on the second client, we have our current canvas state is saved. And our meeting participant increases to 3, and time since beginning is also saved. Here it's showing 8 minutes, and here also it's showing 8 minutes. And public room chat is also saved. And here is the presenter video. Currently, Omkar is the presenter. Now leave this. Log out. Now this person has left, and his video is also not shown. Now, I'll be joining with you.
A couple of other things. This thing here, I am the admin. So you're just seeing my screen, I am the admin. This button here allows me to mute a user. Say I click on this button, Omkar will be muted for all the participants. So his audio will not be transmitted to any participant. This small icon here lets all the other participants know that Omkar is the current controller. If I take back the control, so this indicates that I want to make Yash the current controller. Now I am the controller, that sign is gone. I can see that I am the controller. Now, let's say I mute Omkar. So he can know that he's muted. If I unmute him, that is gone. He can request control. And we'll just try to do something using our mobile phone. We're just waiting for Rishabh to log in. OK. So Rishabh just joined. You can see his video here. He's using his mobile phone. Now, I'll make him the controller. So now Rishabh is the current controller.
I will draw something on canvas.
Clear kar de.
First of all, let me clear the canvas.
So the canvas just got cleared. He is the controller. Whatever he's been drawing is transmitted here and there. And one more thing is, I am the current admin. If I log out, the meeting closes. Say I log out. So it's notified that the admin has left. Your meeting is now closed and it's done. That's it.
I got a problem, okay? You have got too many tabs. There are two problems. Okay, one is, why is a controller required?
To put the restriction that only the admin can draw on the canvas or present a presentation file.
No, that's fine. Okay.
So,
but why I need in a conference?
Correct.
Somebody with superpowers.
Because
okay. Okay, let me continue. That is my one basic problem. Okay. Meaning, you should have a flexibility to have a conference without a complete peer-to-peer conference. Okay, that is my one thing, because you are always saying that this fellow. Okay, when early video conferencing thing, okay, early ones, okay, there were so many video conferences going on. The moment somebody speaks, the control goes automatically. Okay. Right. It was always there. So his screen will come because there were only two pictures, the one who is transmitting and the listener's picture. So if I make a noise, okay, then I become visible to everywhere. That was early video conference which we used in TCS. Early. One of the first video conferencing tools in India was installed in TCS in Nortel. Okay. Just to drive a customer's thing. Okay. So it was always without any controller. Okay. So you have to look at a solution for that. The second problem I have is with so many tabs. Okay. Why are you restricting it to a presentation or a canvas or anything? Why can't I use any tool? Okay. Maybe his concept tutor. Why that cannot be transmitted? So basically my thing is, if I look at it, why don't I have a screen to screen mode? Whatever is available on my screen comes on other people's screen. Okay, you are talking about a camera. Now you put something, only if a canvas, my built canvas is there on the screen, that will be visible. Okay, why not screen to screen? May I just go into video mode or I go into a screen mode? Then that will become very simple. I can run whatever tool I want. I can play a game, commando game, it is visible everywhere. Okay, so why this restriction? That was my second comment.
The simple.
I think what you have done is good, but I think we need to start from the basics. Okay.
The moral of the question is that, do you have screen sharing feature? That's all.
No, we do not have screen sharing feature. One rationale behind that.
In sharing feature,
yes.
Then can I get rid of all your presentation, etc.? One single feature, will it replace all kinds of software you have?
Yes, but that will add a bandwidth cost. Because screen sharing is again video. Right now what the canvas is doing is just JSON objects. So using bandwidth for a video, and instead of using that just to send JSON objects, there's a big difference in the bandwidth that is being consumed. You're streaming.
What are you sharing when you share a canvas?
You're sharing objects. Say I draw a line. The main thing I'm sending is top left, bottom right, or top left, length of the line. That is all is being sent.
No, but that was freehand drawing I saw.
Freehand drawing is one where you have to send all the things. For any shape that you send, anything that can be defined, let's say from the top left is 0, 0, anything that I can say x1, y1, x2, y2 will be sent as x1, y1, x2, y2. It will not be sent as a stream of points. It will be sent as a single object, which will have a length. It will have starting coordinates, end coordinates. So I'm not streaming the entire screen. I'm not sending it point by point. Point by point is sent only once when we do something called real-time drawing. So if you have noticed, what is happening was, if I'm drawing a line, say I start a line from here. I drag it all the way here. Only after I release my mouse will it be transmitted over there. It is not transmitted real time. I have to mouse down, drag, mouse up, it is transmitted. What real time drawing does is it sends a stream of points. So if I'm moving like this, all the points are being sent at the same time to the client. That is an additional bandwidth cost as well. Real time drawing has more bandwidth cost than a line. That is why we are sending objects.
Initially, what did you show? Videos.
Videos.
Correct?
Yes.
So that means when I start the conference, video bandwidth is established.
Correct.
Okay. So when I go from the video mode to the screen mode, okay, am I going to utilize more bandwidth?
Because because you are sending your screen video as well as the other videos are still being received.
Why?
Because
that is up to you. If I want to transmit my screen, okay, I should be allowed to make faces. I just transmit my screen and keep dancing. Why should you send that I am dancing? What is the point? Okay. Why are you treating the two bandwidths as separate? If it is either the video, either the camera is sending or the screen is sending. If I go into that mode, okay, can I get rid of everything?
It will take time to establish connections after that. How this
you already established connection.
Yes.
Videos are going on.
Correct.
Now any person, okay, decides I don't want to send video. I want to send my screen.
So that
is there any impact?
Yes, there is. That requires a re-establishment of connections because that is how WebRTC works. That is why it is peer-to-peer.
You haven't heard me. Okay. Say, I don't care. Okay. My people have always heard me. I don't care about what is this WebRTC.
Correct.
I go from the functional viewpoint. Okay.
Right.
Functional viewpoint is if I am sending a video, I require a certain bandwidth. If I am sending a screen, okay, I probably require lesser bandwidth. Okay, than a video, I think.
Agreed.
Okay. Probably, most probably. Okay. I don't care what is WebRTC. I want to have a functionality where there are 100 users. Okay. Okay. 99 are sharing their video. Okay. One is sharing screen. That's all.
Okay.
What I do on the screen is my business.
Okay. So,
okay.
So
then does the system become more general? Does the software load reduce? Can I do anything not restricted to only I can draw and somebody has not allowed me to draw a Bayesian curve, so I can't do it. Okay. My presentation also I can do. So what is it that I cannot do if I do with only these two elements? One is video and one is screen. These are only two things I transmit. Okay. Third thing, sound if it is separate. Okay. Sound comes along with video, with screen, whether screen sound will not be there or screen plus sound.
Sir, we want more interaction.
What is the difference if I implement a system like this over yours?
Sir, we thought over that, but we need more interaction between the presenter and all the participants. For if I draw on the canvas, the presenter can show by his hand movements or any other objects present over his own chair, which can be shown on the presenter's video.
Okay. See, that is where.
Sir, that is why.
Yes, sir.
Because
between the canvas and the presenter's video. So if you just stream his screen, you won't get that video. If you just stream his webcam video, you won't get the screen video.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is why we have two different streams coming. We don't have two different streams. That is why the original streams are not disconnected. That is why they remain established even when you go to the canvas mode.
Very simple. So what you are telling me is that if, again, I care a hoot about your software, if I want to, okay, also do something other than the screen, I should be allowed to.
Yes, sir.
Correct?
So,
that means I can transmit my thing by saying, please make me 1/4. It's still okay. What I'm saying, the flexibility I have, if I transmit a screen versus all the various things you have developed, okay, that benefit is much more than anything I can see or not. Okay. But then I don't have to wait.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay.
Some new feature comes in, some new technology comes in, I don't care because screen is going to be there.
Okay,
screen is permanent. Picture is permanent. I don't have to reinvent anything.
Okay, sir.
I don't have to write any other software except whatever I have done and whatever I think. Okay. So you are only thinking in terms of bits and pieces. I will allow him to draw a line. Okay. Why? Video play karna hai. Again, this is one application means one tab, yaar. If I have 10 applications, one pura screen tab se bhar jayega. Okay.
Yes,
instead of that, the simplest thing is screen and this, according to me.
Actually, the screen sharing and desktop sharing are the two features in a row. The reason actually we required, and all standard video conferencing software has got the presentation, video, such kind of feature, because they give a lot of dedicated quality and flexibility for the user. Once you upload your presentation, it is available in a box. You are on the move also, you just start it from anywhere. Suppose you are a sales guy, on your box which is available in the login, you just upload the presentation, all the gallery is available. You just start it, present it. So that every time sharing, if you are using mobile or tablet and other thing, so every time it is not possible that your content is with you. So that is why all video conferencing software, if you say the Skype, Hangover, BlueView button, or WebEx, whatever, they all have got this standard feature. So this is the standard suit of feature that all standard software have. We have to match up with their own feature list also. But yes, desktop sharing and the screen sharing, these are two features yet to be developed. They are also in a row.
Once you do that, all the other features not required.
No, the quality you didn't get in a screen sharing. Screen sharing is not a ye garibo ka solution ho jayega.
What do you mean? I see on my screen you get, no? Garibo
sir,
ka
see,
kind.
What we
wanted interactive, we can't have it. I mean, in the canvas, you could see that I can edit and then change the control and then he can edit. That is not possible if you change the screen.
When I transmit both, I can say ki mera pura screen will occupy half the screen at the target here. What is the big problem are you talking
but
about?
But he can't get the same objects now. He can't get the same canvas.
He will. It is on my screen.
But he can't edit it. He can just see it.
So, sir, either
I can't edit it.
No, so this is on your screen, right? Yeah. This is on your screen. You want us to transmit this much desktop share. What we wanted to do was send that also. Send that video also.
And send that also, along with the screen. Okay, the only thing he has said is if I send a screen, okay, that is not editable. That also I can get rid of, but that's okay. I'll accept that as a thing. I'm not convinced at all.
Okay. Sir, either you stream two videos.
I'm here. I can discard all your current solutions and come up with a solution which is very elegant, very easy to use, because why should people talk only about presentations? It's my screen. I can draw anything on it.
Sir, so okay, what I'm saying is, if you wanted to do this, if you wanted to do this using WebRTC, you would have to send two video streams. You can take
anyway,
my
you're
version.
Sending two, no?
No, I'm just sending JSON objects and one video stream. This is not a video. This is just JSON objects. It is not taking the bandwidth of a video. It
my
is
dear guy, if I send a series of images on a screen, okay, I can take care to send only images after they change, no?
I am not sending images. That is
if
what
I
am telling you.
If I give a screen sharing, I need to share the screen only after the screen changes, correct? So it is the same as a video compression. I am not sending a video stream all the time. I can actually compress.
Okay.
When the memory changes, only I have to change.
That is still an image. You agree that image bandwidth is higher than text?
I don't have to send the full image. It's like video sending only. Only after the image changes I send.
Okay, so either you are sending a video.
Only the pixel that I've changed. Meaning actually I'm implementing your canvas only. Okay. When I do freehand on the canvas, you are only sending what has changed, right? That's all I'm changing. Okay. Anyway, it doesn't matter. This is a discussion. I'm convinced, okay, all this is junk. Okay. A new solution which does only these two things, okay, will come and kill everything, because what you are thinking about is video conferencing. What I am thinking about is group sharing. Okay. I don't care about your video conferencing. The bandwidth is going to be cheaper. Okay. The devices are going to be stronger. Okay. I should be able to connect some group of 10-15 people together and do some activity on the fly. That is why I say I don't need a controller. That is the solution we need.
So, okay. If you do not need a controller, whose screen are you going to share? Whose screen? Okay, the controller is the one who's drawing on the canvas. So you have no controller, you are going to share 10 different screens.
Yeah. I'm sending 10 videos, I'm just saying there's no controller.
So if there is no controller, everybody can edit the screen?
Who can decide?
Why?
Why? Okay. Another fundamental thing. Okay. I hate authority. Okay. So it is for the group to decide. I am talking about all peer-to-peer groups. I am talking about small groups. There is no solution right now for small groups to share using something called video conferencing. They don't want to share presentations here.
So
why can't 10 people talk to each other or have a video call with each other, okay, and share whatever they want to do? There are only two things. One is video. One, this idiot has got a camera, okay. And it has got a screen. That is there in all instruments. All I need is technology to connect. Okay. I'm not talking about video conferencing. Video conferencing is for business. I'm talking about for simple people. Okay. A solution is required. If you have WebRTC is there, you should build a solution.
So, sir, if you want to talk and share videos, this is where you do it. What is the problem here? Talk and share.
Presentation, yeah.
Okay, don't use it. Don't use it. Use this videos mode if you want to do, or you want to do
I want
talk.
To share. I want to share my back, whatever you call it. What do you call it there?
History.
Man, screen pe aata hai wo backdrop. I want to share my backdrop. Kaise karunga?
Okay,
It is what you are restricting. I am an ordinary user. I got a device, okay, which has got a camera and a screen. You are not allowing me to share my screen with 10 other people. Why can't you? When the technology is there and when bandwidth is there. I am assuming bandwidth is not an issue. Bandwidth will no longer be an issue. Okay.
Okay. So that
all
is
all solutions designed with bandwidth and issue are dead.
So that is one assumption that we were working with, because I think that is still far-fetched. I think what you are saying, that bandwidth will not be an issue, is far-fetched.
2 years bandwidth is not an issue. It's not far-fetched. 2 years. We have got 4G coming in now. Okay.
Sir, 4G is something that you and I can afford, not everybody
correct.
In a remote place
correct.
Can afford.
Now 4G, everybody will be able to afford in 2 years. Okay. We have seen this mobile starting in 1996 with rupees 16. Okay. 1996, around 2000. Okay. Now everybody and uncle has got mobile. Okay. And in the world, change is very rapid. It is becoming rapider. In 2 years, bandwidth is not an issue.
And if you are
building something, you don't ever build anything for current technology. If you want to build something, build for the future. Okay. Otherwise, you are not ever going to be successful in life, because current is dead in 2 years. Okay. So if you are saying bandwidth is becoming cheaper, you project it. It is going to become more cheaper.
Sir, right now 3G is 250 rupees a GB, right? I don't think people in villages.
I'm an old technology guy. I don't know stuff.
Then video streaming is going to be a problem in bandwidth. If you do not 2G, you cannot stream a video.
Okay.
2G.
Okay.
You
let me summarize. See what they have. What they have developed is the based on our requirement. Let me take the responsibility now. This is based on our requirement. And our requirement is not our requirement. It is the normalization of features available in top class, all video conferencing solutions available. I already mentioned that. What the Cisco WebEx is giving, what Skype is giving, what Hangout is giving, what BigBlueButton is giving, even what AVU is giving, or what actually Panorama is giving. What that is our solution. So the requirement has been given, and based on requirement they have developed. But yes, you say that there should be some solution wherein there should be a sharing of the things. Yes, those 2 points are on the wish list, that we should share a desktop and we should share the screen also. So once this feature are developed, I think that it will be a suite of features out of which whatever somebody want, they can use. So they will give the more flexibility to use for the audience whatever they want, having an entire umbrella of the picture.
The only difference is, you are saying, as we go along, I have got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I will add another 10. All I am saying is, remove all the nodes. Okay. That is the basic difference. Huh. You are doing incremental addition. I am saying, for the future, okay, none of this is required.
Possibly.
No, possibly 100%. There is no possibly about it. Okay.
Okay.
Because you are now catering to a requirement of what he says, the people who can spend 250 rupees or whatever. You're looking at business people doing video conferencing. What I'm looking at is, the people need a solution, the ordinary folks need a solution, the ordinary folks who can share a bandwidth need a solution. They are not going to use this. Currently, this is only for people who can afford. Okay. Now you are trying to build a solution, a cheap solution for people who can afford. Okay. That is incorrect. All the people who can do business conference may as well pay lakhs of rupees here. I don't care about them. Okay. When technology is available, when bandwidth will be available, what will ordinary person use it for is where I am coming from.
You,
okay.
You give the answer, you have got audio conferencing.
Yes, I have got audio conferencing, but I need video conferencing plus screen sharing.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah. That
because audio is currently what I can afford. Video is what I will afford in 2 years. Certainly.
Okay.
That is one aspect.
Okay, time out. We are
going.
Chalo, thanks.
Thank you.